The Iceberg Skating Palace, scene of the ladies' free skate. And after the short program, Yuna Kim in first place, but a virtual tie among the top three, with three Americans in the top seven skaters. Here's a skater we expected to see among the leaders, Mao Asada of Japan, the silver medalist from Vancouver, who finds herself in 16th place. All of Japan must have been crushed by that short program, where she was failed by her trademark, the triple axel.
And it just never happened from the very beginning. It looked like she was going to pull it out, but when her boots collide like this, that means she's not in the right rotation position, comes down a little short, and she just couldn't hang on to that edge, and it cost her the entire rest of the program. She did well on the components, but technically it was a disaster.
Well, after she won silver in the Olympics, she defeated Yuna Kim to win the world championship that year, but then in December 2011 lost her mother and comes to Sochi and has a disastrous short program. She and Yuna Kim, born 20 days apart, rivals since they were juniors, but she won't be pressing her this year.
I admire her so much as an athlete. She laid it all out on the line in the short program, risked everything, and once again, she plans to open with that triple axel.
To think that 4 years ago at the Olympics in Vancouver, she landed three successfully in the competition. Great combination, triple flip into triple loop. But she's completely retooled her jumping technique. She's gone back to the basics because she wanted more consistency in the one jump she had. Triple Lutz. Second half of the program, the technical elements get a bonus, 10%. These points add up so quickly. Usually after the bonus kicks in, you see a lot of jumping passes back to back. You see so many in the bonuses, again, for the points, but in these long programs, they're 4 minutes long, your legs get tired. The longer you're out there, the more tired they get, the harder it is to jump.
This is incredible. Her goal was to land every single triple plus the triple axel. This is how she's been skating in practice. She's so much more than a jumper. And you'll see her passion come through in this final footwork sequence.
to see how devastated she was after that short program, to know this is her last Olympic Games, to know she's completely out of the competition and she throws a free program down like that is just, it says everything you need to know about her. That was fantastic.
Her journey these past 7 years has not been an easy one. And the skating community and her Japanese fans have adored her. She's so beloved for this reason, because she's given her heart every single time she stepped on the ice.
And in her final Olympic skate, she'll have one to remember.
But as a true athlete, she never gave up. She kept on fighting, and this time she did it.
She hasn't hit one clean all year. Again, she gets up in the air this time. It's a lot better, the rotational position, and she comes down just a little short of the rotation, but this time she's in the right position to be able to hang on to that landing.
And then she followed up with an extraordinarily difficult triple flip, triple loop. The loop may have been slightly under-rotated, but nevertheless, those were two beautiful jumps.
And that
her
triple
final
loop,
jump.
That's the one that took her out in the short program. She doubled it, which was just the worst mistake she could have made. And the last jump she does in her Olympic career is that jump. How courageous, how beautifully skated. Extraordinary.
Bittersweet tears from Mao Asada.
The free skating score for Mao Asada of Japan, 142.71.
142.71.
She has a total score of 198.
With a total of 198.22. That's a personal best, and congratulations to her. What a comeback. Don't account the 15-year-old American.